all of the raw material comes out of the Swiss log station, the carry pick in the center of the smart factory, we have it go to the printing station. And this printing station is a special station here because it was designed by two very good partners of ours, FPT and DP. We have Carl from FPT and we have Ramon from DP over here. You guys work together. Maybe I'll start with you, Carl. Could you tell me how the printing cell works, what it's doing, all that stuff?
Well, basically it's a typical robot cell, of course a KUKA robot, and a graphical interface going with it, and also interface to its DP printing solution, digital printing.
We are specialists in printing. We offer different printing solutions, small format to large format, flatbed printing systems and roll-to-roll printing systems. We're working with different inks, kind of inks, water-based inks, solvent-based inks, and UV inks. And especially for this application on the Hannover Fair, we choose the UV system because the ink is will be dried during the process and we can handle the puzzle immediately.
The other thing I heard, not from you, but earlier from another colleague of ours, is that there were some special considerations for this one because it had to be safe in case children were eating the puzzle pieces, correct? How did we get around this?
Yeah, we did some printing tests just before the Hannover Fair to test if we can fulfill the needs of EN71. And we tested it with this special kind of UV.
One thing we talked about earlier was this graphical programming interface. So this idea of simplifying programming, could you talk about that? That's an FPT solution, correct?
Well, yes, it's basically also a market requirement to make everything easier. It's the same as the idea of programming a smart pad with icons so everybody can handle it because customer usually has no specialist anymore, they are expensive. So you have to have the access to the technology for kind of anybody. So we design these graphical interfaces, whatever the customer needs to have a standard for programming.
And what I've seen of it, it looks really cool. You just sort of drag and drop icons for programming. You can do pick and place and all this other stuff, stuff that tends to be pretty complicated to program with code. You can do it pretty easily with the graphical programming. Of course, in a smart factory, it's not just about the individual application or the individual cell. And you guys are already working together between your two companies and getting the interface there. But how do you take all of this information and then handle the data that's coming in and the data that's going out so that the process continues on and you can track the customer's products as they go through?
Yeah, we are getting the printed image from the KUKA system. So we have four different images and they are stitching the image to one piece together. And it will be sent or provided at the digital printing machine. And we are just sending the printing data to the machine.
And I also saw that on the actual image itself, there's a QR code printed, correct? How does that fit into the rest of the process?
Because basically the main data, whatever the machine produces or the process or the order, are kept in the QR code with the data in behind in a cyber physical world, and you have access wherever.
So there you have it, guys. That QR code that these guys are printing and then tracking, they're even using it in the system. In that system, the QR code then drives the data as it moves forward to make sure as the thing is getting laser cut to the next station and glued at the next station and delivered ultimately to the customer. That's the digital shadow you have. Thank you guys so much for looking at our printing station with our two partners, FPT and DP. Please check out all of our other videos about the smart factory, including all the stations here, and we'll see you later. Intelligenz.